GamerSpawn.
Newest entry in the Call of Duty video game series, Modern Warfare 2, is being praised for its ultra-realistic gaming experience.
They imitate that, but they just like video games, but of course you can download it off the internet.
Violence and aggression.
They say there's no such thing as bad press, as negative attention is still attention, and is perhaps even more powerful than the positive kind.
How is this any different, as many would say, than kids playing cops and robbers?
Still, it's hard to imagine what went through the minds of some of the following public relations spokesmen when they thought of these ideas. Dante's Inferno protest. July 9th, 2009, a group of 13 protesters gathered by one of the entrances to the Los Angeles Convention Center. They were apparently there to protest Dante's Inferno, the 2010 game based off the literary classic of the same name. The protesters declared EA the Antichrist, amongst other religious-oriented protests.
I'd like to say that Electronic Arts is some sort of Antichrist for trying to make this game Dante's Inferno.
Which game?
I don't know if that's... Well, Dante's Inferno, particularly this game that they're we've heard that they are promoting inside, and we want to say that this game, we hope that it never comes to market. Let's just be honest with that. We hope that it never comes. That we hope this game never comes out. We hope that.
They got the attention of various journalists and reporters, who then, of course, spread the word. Wiser people suspected a publicity stunt immediately, as the brochures they handed out pointed to wearesavedgroup.org, which promoted and bashed the game, as well as contained trailers and footage. A few days later, EA admitted the stunt, and not long after, real protesters started bashing EA for the protest, claiming it was anti-Christian. Snoop Dogg blows up an armored truck.
When the pimp's in the crib, ma, drop it like it's hot.
In a move that is either ridiculous, brilliant, or both, social gaming behemoth Zynga hired on Snoop Dogg to help promote their game Mafia Wars Las Vegas in early August 2010. They rather cleverly stated that when the game reached 10 million users, they would celebrate by detonating an armored truck in the Las Vegas area desert and live stream the entire thing. But they didn't mention that Snoop Dogg was doing it.
Two, I understand the mafia culture. And for three, you know, I'm trying to destroy the evidence. I know how to make it happen.
Kind of makes you wish you were awesome enough to get paid to drive out to a desert and blow up a car, doesn't it?
So don't change the diesel, turn it up a little. I got a living room full of fine dime bristles, waiting on the pistol, the diesel, and the shizzle. G's to the diss act, now ladies, if we kiss her.
When the pimp's in the crib, ma.
Sony's God of War 2 release party in Athens.
By defeating Ares, Kratos, the once mortal warrior, became the new god of war.
Back in 2007, Sony threw a big old launch party in Athens. They did it right. Well, almost. They had togas, scantily clad women, drinks, food you could eat that came from the inside of a decapitated goat. Yeah, not really sure what they were thinking about that last one either. Apparently, because God of War is a violent franchise, Sony thought it'd be best to keep that in line with the series. So they bought a, presumably previously, dead goat, decapitated and stuffed it with offal, then proceeded to offer guests to reach inside and eat some of that intestinal goodness. So apparently this somehow didn't go over well with just about anyone, and they had to recall almost 80,000 magazines to try and hide the scandal. But pictures did make it to the internet. And well, just take a look here.
I've got to work right now. Job people must work. Reggae people must work.
Capcom's missing body parts. A Also back in 2009, Capcom Europe decided to try their hand at shocking people into buying their then latest game, Resident Evil 5. So, reasonably, they organized a competition in London and asked participants to find bloody body parts around the city for a trip to Africa. Once they found said body parts, Capcom told the participants to gather on the bridge, holding the artificial body parts over their heads and shouting, "Kajuju!" as part of the competition. That couldn't have looked weird, right? Apparently, some non-participants were tempted to take the body parts and did so, causing quite a few of the limbs to go missing. The body parts were also smeared in chicken livers and blood, which surprisingly are a large contamination risk due to disease. So, to avert panic, Capcom decided to issue a statement, asking people to either return the body parts to the publisher or to dispose them in a responsible and careful manner. They also added that chicken livers were used for added gore, which uncooked can be dangerous. Though they probably did not get back all the limbs, luckily for Capcom, no charges were made, although some residents did complain. Homefront's balloons and YouTube advert. THQ decided to get their word across in a big way. In March of 2011, THQ first decided to release 10,000 red balloons with advertisements about the game in San Francisco, California. These balloons made it over the San Francisco Bay, which apparently has a very delicate ecosystem. The city itself is very conscientious about adding more pollution, so this did not go over well. Activists tweeted and protested and shouted at GameStop, who they believed to be the perpetrator. Later, GameStop posted a response on their Facebook telling the balloon drop stunt was created by THQ and that they had no prior knowledge of it. They added that THQ has since informed them that they released soy-based biodegradable balloons. A few weeks later, THQ kept with their Homefront advertising campaign and decided to once again get people's attention in a big way. For a short period of time, when you visited YouTube, a banner took over the whole front page stating that North Korea had attacked the US. Even we remember being confused as we looked at the banner to try and determine what we were seeing and what this meant. We then followed through with the link and realized it was just an advert for Homefront.
The Chunun and took the lives of 46 South Korean sailors was fired by a North Korean submarine.
Needless to say, we were not the only one a bit annoyed by the banner. Unfortunately, most people did not even check to see if it was real and rushed on social networks to declare the news. Even though it was labeled as an advertisement, and when you clicked on it, it took you to a Homefront trailer. Although many people were upset, it definitely did work in getting attention to the game, negative or otherwise. However, in a time where war is ever likely, it wasn't the most tasteful way to market their game. And that concludes our small list of strange video game publicity stunts. And in case we forgot one, please post it in the comments section below. Make sure to check out Delta Gamer for more lists.
Stops thinking and my eyes stop blinking. I know at the end.